sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving we every moment sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment, O sacrament most holy, O sacrament divine, all praise and all thanksgiving be every moment, be every moment.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, these moments of adoration, we are here in the presence of our Lord because the Lord has called us and we respond unto Him with this call. It's also because we trust, we hope, we connect with our Lord, and our Lord lives in our heart. And at this evening, as we are worshiping our Lord, we are proclaiming to the whole world that our Lord present in this Eucharistic bread is the source, is the strength, and is the end of our life. He helps us to move ahead every step of our way. If He were not there with us, if we didn't believe in Him, it would have been impossible for us to go ahead in our life as we are now. And so we are here to thank our Lord, especially today, for all the blessings, for all the help we have received from Him. Let our hearts tell our Lord, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Abba Father. Thank you, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Abba Father, for your children, for your love to me as your children. O Jesus Christ, for your love and for your sacrifice to save me. O Holy Spirit, thank you for your anointing and strength in my life, especially today. Let us worship our Lord. Let us adore our Lord with all the angels and saints today. Thank you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We adore you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Let your name be glorified always and everywhere. O bread of life, we adore you. O Holy Spirit, the power from above, we worship you. Abba, Father, thank you. Hallelujah. 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 With the whole court of heaven, let us lift up our heart unto our Lord, a heart full of thanks, a heart full of love, a heart full of joy to our Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Every time when we come into the presence of our Lord and to thank Him and to worship Him, especially at the end of every day, do we ever feel in our heart that the blessings that I have received is enough in my life? Don't we ever feel that I need more and more and more and more of your blessings? Have you ever said no or enough to the love of our Lord? The more we experience His love, the more we experience His presence, the more we would want it again. And that is what in the book of Lamentations the writer rightly said. His love is new every morning. It is never the same every day. It is never equal every day. It is new. And our heart always long for more and more of His love. Thank you, Lord. And it is also that the Lord never exhausted in His love. He has more and more of His love to share with us every day. That is why Saint Paul would say, is there anyone who have experienced the breadth, the width, the height, and the length of the love of the Lord? He also prayed for His people who listens to Him to have a heart with all the saints to experience the love, its breadth, its width, its height, and its length, the love of the Lord. Let us ask of His love more and more into our life, because it is only His presence that will satisfy us. It is only His presence that will transform us. It is only His presence and His hand that will strengthen and save us. Everything that we receive from our fellow brethren on earth, it has limitations. But His love, His hand, His strength, it is never limited. Thank you, Lord. Lord, fill our hearts more and more of Your love. We believe if we experience Your love, whether we have any sorrow, any burden on this earth, it will never disappoint us. We might cry, but our heart will always be joyful in our Lord. Lord, fill our hearts with love. Fill our hearts with Your love, Your true love. Thank You, Lord. We worship You, Lord. We adore You, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Worshipping our Lord and asking more and more of His love and presence with us. Let's join with this hymn with our heart. Lord, what I need is You. More and more and more of You in our life, we pray.
More than the next heartbreak, more than
Let us sing together with more of our love to our Lord. The centurion prayed, if you say a word, Lord, that is enough. We would like to hear more and more from you. Thank you, Lord. Worship you, Lord. We adore you, Lord. We glorify your holy name. Let us offer our future unto the Lord. This day is ending. We do not actually know what the next moment holds for us. Joy, sorrow, whatever it is, we do not know. But we are ready to receive it from the hand of the Lord. Let us offer our future, all our next moments into the hand of our Lord. And we know we are safe in the hands of our Lord. He holds our future and He has a plan. He has a plan about our future for our good, for our well-being. Trusting in that, let us offer. If we had planned anything, if we have planned anything for our future, any events, any celebrations, plans for achievements, let us offer all that into the hand of the Lord at this time. And trusting in the Lord, let us acknowledge you, Lord. Have your way in our life. And in whatever way you use our life, you guide our life as we surrender ourselves unto you, let your name be glorified. Let's also offer a family. If there is anyone sick physically or emotionally or even spiritually, anyone suffering, let us offer that unto the Lord. Our extended family, our immediate blood relatives, our departed souls from our family, our beloved ones, we offer all of them into the hand of the Lord and we pray, Lord, have your way in our family. Strengthen our faith. Purify our relationships. And let your Holy Spirit guide and anoint each one of us. We pray, O Lord. O Lord, have your way. Let's also spend a few moments interceding for the world as we entrust ourselves and our family unto the Lord. Let us entrust the whole world as well into the hands of the Lord, into His protection, into His mercy, into His healing. All our brethren suffering, especially from COVID-19, all over the world, let us offer them unto the protective hands of our Lord. We remember all those who have asked our prayers. From Divine Retreat Center, with all the prayers that are dear to your own hearts, we lift up all the prayer intentions that we have received in different media. And Lord, we pray, have mercy on our prayer intentions. Offering ourselves and surrendering the whole world, let us pray Psalm 91, the assurance of God's protection. You who live in the shelter of the Most High, who abide in the shadow of the Almighty, will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom I trust. For he will deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. For he will deliver. His faithfulness is a shield and buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, or the arrow that flies by day, or the pestilence that stalks in darkness, or the destruction that waves at noonday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only look with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. Because you have made the Lord your refuge, the Most High your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, no scourge come near your tent. For he will command his angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. On their hands they will bear you up, so that you will not dash your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the adder, the young lion and the serpent you will trample underfoot. Those who love me, I will deliver. I will protect those who know my name. When they call to me, I will answer them. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. With long life, I will satisfy them and show them my salvation. Amen. Once again, entrusting ourselves unto the Lord, praying for a good rest this evening and a peace of our heart, a joy-filled heart. Let us kneel down before our Lord, preparing for the moments of benediction. singing together down in adoration falling. Lord our God, in this great sacrament, we come into the presence of Jesus Christ, your Son, born of the Virgin Mary and crucified for our salvation. May we who declare our faith in this fountain of love and mercy drink from it the water of everlasting life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray the divine graces. Blessed be God, blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God, in his angels and in his saints. Amen.